हेलो नमस्ते आदाब सत श्री अकाल। यस डियर स्टूडेंट्स, अगेन वी आर ऑन द सेम प्लेटफॉर्म बट विद डिफरेंट चैप्टर और डिफरेंट टॉपिक। व्हाट इज इट? इट इज एसिड बेस एंड साल्ट। सो स्टूडेंट्स, वी कैन कैटेगराइज द केमिकल सब्सटेंसेज इनटू थ्री डिफरेंट कैटेगरी। फर्स्ट इज एसिड, सेकेंड इज बेस, थर्ड इज साल्ट। Now, what are the acids? This acid word is generated from a Latin word that is acidus. And what is acidus means? Acidus means sour. So the chemical substances that have the sour taste and release hydrogen or hydronium ion in the presence of water are known as acid. Many times you take fruits, there are some fruits have sour taste. It means what they contain? They contain acid in them, like grapes, orange, lemon, citrus fruit. So what they contain? They contain the particular acid in them, and due to that acid they can also pass the electric current, student. How? Because when the acids are found inside the water, then what they do? They release hydrogen or hydronium ion, and with the help of this they can conduct the electricity. And if we speak about the chemicals, there are many chemicals are found inside the lab. So in those chemicals there are some substances belong from this category, that is acid. Like there is one strong acid that is generally found in the lab, and we should be careful about that. That is sulfuric acid. And that sulfuric acid is also found in the batteries, means the charges that are found inside the battery, those all charges are contained inside that acid. Like this, there is another acid, and that acid is also produced inside our body. And in which organ it is produced? It is stomach. And that acid is known as hydrochloric acid. Hydrochloric acid is also found in the laboratory. Like this, there is another acid, that is nitric acid. And nitric acid is also found in the lab. Now, what is the main characteristic from which we can know that the particular substance is acid? With the help of this nature, means the chemical substances that release hydrogen or hydronium ions in the presence of water are known as acid. Like there is one example is given in this, that is HCl. When HCl react with water, then what it is releasing? It is releasing hydrogen ion and chlorine ion. Like this, when this hydrogen ion is reacted with water, then it also releases hydronium ion. So hydrogen and hydronium ion are released by the acid in the presence of water. And how can we know the nature of these chemical substances? Here I make one strip. So this type of strips are also found in the laboratory, and what we call those strips? Those strips are known as litmus paper. And that litmus paper, students, is obtained from one plant that have the symbiotic relationship. And what we call that plant? That plant is known as lichen. So with the help of the lichen, what we get? We get the litmus paper as well as litmus solution. And with the help of that litmus solution, we can know the nature of these chemical substances. Like there is blue litmus paper. With the help of the blue litmus paper, we can know the presence of acid. Like in the presence of acid, that blue litmus paper is turned into red. Is turned into red. And with the help of this simple code, you can learn it. B for blue, blue litmus paper, in the presence of acid, is turned into red. So with the help of this simple code, you can learn it. It is bar. B for blue, A for acid, R for red. Means blue litmus paper is turned into red litmus paper in the presence of acid. There is another characteristic that they have the pH in between 0 to 7, 0 to 6.9, we can write here, 6.9. If they have the pH 0 to 6.9, then we can say that that particular chemical substance belongs from acid. And it is about the acid. And they are irritative in nature, means if they are found in our skin or if we touch them with our naked hand, then they are irritative or corrosive in nature. Irritative or corrosive in nature. Now we come on the next type of chemical substance, and we use that chemical substance in the form of soap, student. Daily you take the bath, and you take bath with the help of base, and that base is found in the soap. So base word is generated from S word. As you know that S have the soapy touch, so like that they also have soapy in touch, means they are soapy in nature. If we touch them, then we feel softness, we feel the softness. And if we speak about their definition according to the chemistry, the chemical substances that release hydroxide ion in the presence of water are known as base, student. And if we speak about the example, there is one particular chemical substance is found inside the laboratory, that is sodium hydroxide, NaOH. It is also known as caustic soda. When we react it with water, means when it is found inside the water, then it releasing the ion in the form of sodium and hydroxide. So we can say that the chemical substances that release hydroxide ion in the presence of water are known as base. And if the base are found with water or aqueous foam, then that particular base is known as alkali, student, alkali. So it is about the base. In the laboratory we have the different type of base, like sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, NaCO3, that is known as baking soda, Na2CO3.10H2O, that is known as washing soda. So there are the different bases are found inside the laboratory. Now we come on the next form of the chemical substance, that is salt. Before that we will discuss this thing also. Like here is another strip I have made here, and it is red litmus paper. That red litmus paper turns into blue in the presence of base, and you can learn it with the help of this simple code. It is rubber. It is rubber. What we call it? Rubber. RBB. Means red litmus paper is turned into blue in the presence of base. And they have the pH in between 7.1 to 14. And if we speak about their taste, then they have, means all the bases have bitter taste. Which type of taste they have? They have bitter taste. Now we come on the next type of the chemical substance. It is about the salt. Students, there are the three different type of salt are found: acidic salt, basic salt and neutral salt. So in this segment we will discuss about the neutral salt. Neutral salt are the chemical substances that release neither hydrogen nor hydroxide ion. Means they release other ions in the presence of water. And the example of neutral salt is sodium chloride, that is also known as common salt, table salt. Why do we call it table salt? Because generally it is found on our dining table. And if about the salty food, if there is no salt, then we don't feel any taste. So that salty taste is provided by the common salt. And what is it? It is sodium chloride. So here again you will learn the reaction when the NaCl is reacted with water, then it releases sodium and chlorine ion. So it is an example of releasing of ion of sodium chloride. So sodium chloride is a neutral salt. Now we come on the testing of it, that from which category it comes. Means they all the salts, if they are neutral, then they don't change the color of the litmus paper. Means that litmus paper will not change the color. Means if it is blue, then it remains blue. If it is red, then it remains red only. And if we speak about its pH, then the pH of the salt is 7. 7 is the pH of the salt. Means if the salt is neutral, then it should have the 7 pH. And if we speak about its taste, then if the salt is neutral, then the salt taste is salty. Means which type of taste we will have? We will have the salty taste if the salt is neutral, like the table salt, that is sodium chloride. So it is about the acid, base and salt. In the next segment we will discuss about the indicators and the chemical reaction that takes place in between the acid and base. So thank you very much, student, and have a nice day.